action, recoil operated, magazine fed. What's up, everybody? This is the Mad Swede. Almost every time I go to the shooting range for some practice, I have been asked a certain question over and over again. The question has been asked by predominantly brand new shooters. These people have just been introduced into the world of firearms, and they just acquired their very own and very first firearm. The question goes like this. How do I break my firearm down? I don't know where to start. What do I do? With that said, I want to talk about field stripping a firearm today. Every firearm is unique. They have all different bits and pieces everywhere. They all look different. There is one thing every firearm has in common, and that is they all need to be broken down in a certain sequence and be put back in a certain sequence for it to work. So yeah, today I thought, I just want to show real quick how it's done. So yeah, let's go. Okay, I just put my concealed carry pistol down on my workbench, my Springfield XD chambered in 40 Smith & Wesson. It's a subcompact. We're gonna take it apart and see what we got in there. But first, we want to make sure it's empty, chamber is clear, before we start doing anything with it. Finger off the trigger at all times. Remove the magazine. Like so. We're gonna open up the action. We're gonna look, feel, and there's nothing there. You find something on every pistol that's called a takedown lever. Now they vary in shape, form, such as. And they can be found on either the left-hand side of the slide or the right-hand side of the slide. In this case, on my Springfield, it can be found on the left-hand side. So we're gonna go and open up the action one more time. We're gonna press this takedown lever up at 12 o'clock. We're going to release the slide gently. We're gonna squeeze the trigger to release tension, and presto, the slide comes off. You find something called a guide rod with a guide rod spring. We're gonna go ahead and remove that. And since this guide rod and guide rod spring still under some spring suspension, be careful when you remove it because you don't want this to shoot back at you in your chest. And you might lose it if you're extremely unlucky or unfortunate. We're going to remove the barrel by lifting it up, pull it backwards. There you go. This is how far I'm allowed to go on my Springfield, because according to Springfield, I will void the warranty if I proceed to go any further, such as removing the firing pin block. If there is something wrong with this, with the pistol, I need to send it in to Springfield to a certified technician. I am not a licensed gunsmith, and therefore I don't want to mess with it. And I also want to keep my warranty. This thing, it varies on what type of manufacturer you're dealing with. If you own a Glock, if you own a Springfield or whatever, it may vary how far you're allowed to take it apart. This is just a Springfield though. How do we put this back together? Well, reverse order. Take the slide and the barrel, put it right back in, and you're gonna hear a distinct click. There. Your barrel has now locked up with a slide. It won't go anywhere. We're gonna reinsert the guide rod spring. Till you hear a little click, which means it snapped back in place. Take your fully assembled slide and put it back on the frame by aligning it to the guide rails. Hook the slide up and press the takedown lever down. Release the slide gently. There we go, fully assembled. All we need to do now is to make sure it works by performing a simple function test by moving the slide back and forward. Yep. She's working just fine. When you break down your firearm, it's all about practice, practice, practice. So take your time with it. Don't rush it. I can do this fairly fast if I want to, because I had this pistol for quite some time and I'm proficient with it. So I'm gonna break it down the way I do it. Put it back together now. So there you go. Field stripping a firearm is not a big deal after all, is it? Have fun with your firearm. Familiarize yourself with it. Get to know it. Become its friend. YouTube, research, Google it, ask someone for help. There is nothing wrong with asking someone for help. Refer to the operations manual. Take your time. Once you learn the basic steps on how to break your firearm down, it's up to you to train on it and sharpen your skills you just learned. That all goes back to one of my previous videos, learning versus training. It may take you 100 times before you feel confident enough and proficient. But once you do get that confidence, I guarantee you, you won't have any problems doing it whatsoever. You can do this in your sleep. I guarantee you. This is the Mad Swede. Be safe, be nice, and I see you at the range